Welcome back. I'm back. And okay, those of you who know me know that I will relentlessly poke fun kindly at people who apologize without reason. I'm going to start out tonight with an apology, but it is for a good reason. I am really sorry for all the dropped frames so far tonight. It is only partially because of the fireworks show. It is mostly because Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is still goddamn downloading. And it has 12 minutes left before it's ready to play. That's not even completely done downloading. It's telling me it's got another 12 hours left to download. I started downloading all of the PS Plus freebies at 11 o'clock this morning. And it is not even done downloading everything. So, if you are tight for space on your PS4 or PS5, don't even bother with COD Blops Black War or Cold War, because it will take up at least 175 gigabytes of space on your hard drive. As soon as I see that it's ready to play, I'm gonna stop the download and the quality should pick up. But we'll see what it considers suitable for ready to play. I will let it continue downloading, so if, you know, worst case, if it's not a good showing tonight, I can still get some good footage for the video on Thursday. But yeah. It's one of those days where I am very glad that the Xbox Games with Gold thing goes live on the 1st. So I can usually get that downloaded ahead of time, and then I only have to worry about the PlayStation stuff on the actual day itself. But yeah, this is kind of ridiculous. Oh yeah, and I'll be deleting it as soon as I'm done with the video. Because I don't really care to have this taking up that much space on my hard drive. I've deleted stuff that I actually enjoy from my hard drive to make space for other stuff, you know, because I know I can put it back there later. This is not an economical use. And okay, so the 175 gigabytes is just the main executable. There are 9 additional items to download aside from that, and I know that one of them is almost 2 more gigabytes. So yeah, this is kind of stupid. So it's got 9 minutes left before it's ready to play. So 9 minutes left before the quality of the stream will hopefully pick up again, because yeah, it's bringing my poor 25 gigabits per second download speed to its knees. So yeah, this is the first week where I'm only going to be streaming on Tuesday. It didn't feel like I did a lot of work over the weekend, but I had a lot of, like, I had to assemble the videos and assemble videos and render videos, and after I'm done with the stream, I'm going to be uploading the videos. I've got 8 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. So 9 demo discs worth of videos ready to upload, and probably about 6 or 7 demo discs worth of cool moves to upload. So, you know, I've been just basically watching progress indicators. Actually, you know what? I put this together for a reason. So this is me talking about progress toward the website and such like that. So basically the progress that I've been making toward the website this weekend has been assembling those videos. The 2 PS2 demo discs are, they had to be split up into 2 pieces each for the extras and for the playground. So going forward, instead of just seeing the summary videos on Thursday, because the PS1 discs, you could easily fit them into a single video, and it's not too bad. Episode 40 or issue 44 was another story. That one's like almost 4 hours long. That was a rough one. But for the PS2 demos, there'll be the extras posting on Wednesday, and then the playground, the actual demo discs and the regular trailers will post on Thursday. So you'll get cool moves, extras, and playground. Once I've got all of those uploaded and I've got all of the descriptions ready to go and the tweets all preloaded, that basically gives me 2 months where I don't have to worry about putting together more videos. And I can kind of get a good start on the website itself. So that will, so it's one of those things where it may not be progress on the website, but it is progress toward the website, you know, because the website is going to have the have links to all of these videos on it. I've also kind of been toying around with a different user interface. But in my quest for simplicity, I also have to keep in mind functionality. And making something that will, you know, not only be pleasant to look at and unobtrusive, but will also be functional and not a pain in the ass to navigate. So I am definitely going to be putting a lot of thought into the user interface aside from that. Right now I've got two different ideas for it. The first one may end up being the best as far as usability is concerned. But it's still, that still may be too simplistic as well. I still have a lot of stuff to think about as far as what categories I want. As far as like, you know, say click on cool moves and it shows you all the cool moves stuff, or click on PlayStation Magazine and it shows you all the PlayStation Magazine stuff. Having it sort automatically is going to be an interesting trick to pull off. But a lot of it is also if I can get things working automatically more behind the scene. Programming stuff like this is very much the more work you do ahead of time, the less work you have to do later on. And that's what I'm working toward. I am going to write as much as I can, trying to make it so that when I need a new page to go live, all I have to do is add stuff, add some entries to a, add some entries to a, an SQL table, and it'll automatically generate the page. Don't have to do anything more than that. Like, the only thing that I would have to touch with the website itself would be maintenance and bug fixes. Because the easier I can keep that for maintenance, the more likely I will accomplish my vision of what I want it to be. So I'm definitely thinking ahead on this. But it's probably going to be a while before I have much of anything to show you guys. Hopefully by the time those the current batch of videos is done. I would like to see something at least showable by the end of August. My main goal is to try to have the site up and running by the end of this year. Because I want to have it live for a couple of months before MGC. So that when MGC comes around, I can kind of focus on trying to, I guess the word that keeps coming to mind is capitalize on it. Where like I would like to do the a panel with some with Game Rave and Round 2 Gaming about the ephemera of gaming that might get lost in collections, and having my website up and established at that point would make more sense. So yeah, that's where I am right now. The whole point of this was I had said early on that I was also going to use these Tuesday night streams to kind of keep myself accountable and tell you where I am with the development of the website, so that it all is, so that it kind of keeps me going with it. Kind of like video games, where if I have the Cold War just finished downloading, but now I have to pause a whole bunch of other stuff. These additional content patches are all, like, ridiculous. But yeah, so if I have something like this, where I can say, you know, this is what I'm doing, this is what I've been doing over the past week, it's more likely to spur me to keep going. Kind of like with playing Phantasy Star 2. I have started that game a number of times over the years. But I've never finished it before. So that's what I'm hoping to do with these long streams. Alright, so as you may have guessed from the fact that that the stream has smoothed out, Call of Duty is done downloading for now, so yay. I was also kind of babbling a little bit more than I usually intend to for these news segments. I'll take care of that. Just because I wanted to waste that time before I started actually playing games. So let's go ahead and switch over to the Xbox, and we are going to play Darkwood first tonight. Okay, I was going to say, hopefully it's going to be more interesting than Adios was last month, but I think that's going to be a pretty low bar. Okay, good. Thank you. Let's see here. Capture options. No. Start recording. There we go. Hello. Oh, okay, good. There was just a little bit of a delay between me pressing any button and it actually responding to me pressing any button. Oh, crunching koalas. Okay. Options. Alright, need to get a little bit of footage of the intro screen. You know, these have been causing a little bit of trouble for me with the YouTube Shorts form factor, but this one's perfect. Like, even if I did, you know, 16:9 vertical and not just the 1:1 square, this would actually work pretty well. But I've actually had to, like, kind of squish things around and make it so that it would fit when it's in a full screen format. Nope. Okay, so normal is the lowest difficulty level. So option enables additional cool but immersion breaking content. I'm gonna say no for now. Oh, I have to hold the play button down. Got it. X button next to the object indicates that more than one action can be performed. Okay. You are playing a challenging and unforgiving game. You will not be led by the hand. Respect the woods, be patient, and focus. Okay. Prolegue. I see hatred and fear in their eyes. As if I was responsible for the spreading disease. As if I were the source of all the misery plaguing this land. I've nowhere to hide from them, nowhere to run. The woods have closed us off from the outside world. We are all doomed. Well, that's the game. Okay. I was expecting first-person view. Oh, that's cool. Kind of pushed the chair. Examine potatoes. The only edible thing growing on this land. I still have some left. Alcohol distiller. It's probably where I use the potatoes. I know these notes by heart. I don't want to read them now. Okay. Right. Is that right trigger? So. Hold on for a second. I hate to do this, but the. The edges of the screen are not let's see here calibrate no sure we'll do that. Trying to figure out where I can fix the zoom on the screen, because usually there's a way to adjust the visible area. And I would assume that it's under the TV and display options, but I'm not finding anything here. Okay, well, I guess it didn't like that option. Despite the fact that it's an HDMI output. Now, hopefully, it's doing a, you know, click if you can see this thing. But just on the off chance that it's not. Okay. Well, let's reboot the Xbox and see if that helps. Oh, fantastic. Well, this is weird. I tried to log in using Remote Play on the Xbox, and I'm just getting a blank screen there too, so. Right, let's try one more thing here. Still nothing. Well, you know what? I feel like doing one more bit of troubleshooting first here. Okay, one sec here. There's no reason what I did should have rendered my Xbox unviewable. Like, even to remote play, this is kind of stupid. Okay, now one more thing here. Is apparently at some point I must have stepped on the, there we go, on the camera plug. We got fixed. For some reason, the Xbox was in 640 by 480 resolution, which apparently my TV and everything did not like. So, we're kind of back to where we were before, unfortunately, but I'll deal. Okay, capture options. Start recording. Let's try this again. I'm sorry about the rocky start to the evening here. I swear I haven't forgotten how to live stream. Okay, no Indiegogo content. Normal difficulty. Hold down the play button. Respect the woods, be patient, focus. Yep. So there we go, 45 minutes into the live stream, and we're starting to play the game. Hooray! And I didn't really have a very good idea of what I was supposed to be doing right off the bat. I was just kind of mucking about. Part of the problem that I was running into was that I wasn't entirely sure, what was going on with the UI. It's also a very dark game, and I've got a bright frickin' ring light in my face. I like the art style. I know these notes by heart. I don't want to read them now. Okay, take everything. Okay. Oh, okay. Got it. So the little D-pad marker there was just because there were multiple things that I could do something with. Barricade and open. All right, well, that doesn't sound good. Generator's almost out of juice. I need to find a full gasoline can. Saw a broken tractor to the east. Maybe I can find some gasoline there. An old camera, useless medical bag, and a photo. $12,685. So that's either December 6th or June 12th. Oops. So I pulled the right trigger to transfer all, but it sure hasn't done that. Cage? This time they're empty. I thought that was like a bed. That's probably another cage. Okay, there's the speed up. I just heard a gun. Radio has been silent for years, although sometimes I think I can hear voices through the static. Okay. Oh, I bet it's transfer all in that one thing. Interesting. Almost looks like medical notes on, like, a zombie plague or something. Well, I'm definitely... Hey! Definitely hearing fireworks outside. Block jammed a long time ago. Never mind. I used to keep useless junk in there anyway. I could open it with a lockpick. Okay, I'll keep that in mind if I ever find a lockpick. I'd rather not open it. I spent too much time to lock him in there. Him who? Unlocked. Okay, we're outside now. Wooden doll. Used to be a luxury, but since all the access roads have been devoured by the woods, it became a useless pile of trash. The Polish People's Republic. Alright. Oh. I would, but I can't. I don't have anything that I could do that with. At least I don't think I do. I mean, a matchstick, alcohol, and a rag. Barricaded window. Should probably keep that barricaded. Wait, what was this again? Ah, destroyed well. Alright, so you can't run for very long. Oh, I see the white bar must be stamina. Okay, we'll take all of that. Take a nail. I'm not quite sure... what I'm supposed to be doing. Because I couldn't go very far outside. Okay, yeah, it is European notation because I'm seeing like 250283. but I want to. Because I can't think of anywhere else that I can do... anything else I can do right now. Ah, here we go. My tools, they haven't been sterilized for years. The local patients can't be helped anyway. Oh, press B and push the left stick in the obstacle's direction to vault over a window or fence. So that's probably... There we go. Well, here we go. At least I've got something resembling a weapon. Select, put it there. Okay, right analog stick spins you around. With weapon selected in your hotbar, hold left trigger to aim and then right trigger to attack. Got it. Dead cow. Silly cow, it's a bear trap, not a cow trap. It shouldn't have affected you. I heard that. Oh, no, that was just the location thing. Okay. Your position on the map is not marked. When you discover a new location, it will be added to your map. Your current location is indicated in red. In order to get lost, you need to learn how to determine your position relative to the discovered locations and landmarks. Oddly enough, I had figured out that that red mark was where I was, because I had figured out from the landmarks. Where on the map I was. I wish it didn't light up in the corner like that. Makes me think that... like there's something up there. I was hoping I could actually, you know, use that matchstick and light a fire. Figure the wardrobe is going to be my stash. Okay, can't go over there any further. Let's head back this way then. These parts of the woods are dark. I should craft a torch. There we go. I don't know how to do what. You just did. Oh. So it looks like I'm going to be coming up on another house. actually going to be something I can get into, or... In a few days it will be completely absorbed. Okay, I guess... Can't take any more of those. Plenty of rags around here. I shouldn't be, wanting for torches. Interesting. Wonder if I can build that little house up to a secondary shelter. It's kind of interesting how they work the layering with the light there. Like, you don't see the corpse there unless the light is shining over it. And yes, that sweep will probably make it into the video, because that was kind of cool. To enter Farluk, hold right trigger and use the right stick to move the cursor. It's not a very far look thing. I think this one is still breathing. Big metal key. He's unconscious. I've never seen him around here before. He's only carrying a key and some journal. Since he managed to sneak in here, he must know how to get out. Of course, he won't help me voluntarily. But that... is of no importance. Well, dubious ethics going on here. I need to get out of this accursed forest. You hear me, rat? Show me how and I'll let you go. Sometimes hear her voice. She's calling me. Calling me to return home. Where is the exit? Where? Show me where! He's not gonna kill you like a dog if I have to. I haven't killed the dog yet. It's not gonna be very helpful if he's freaking unconscious. He has a mouth, you know, full of teeth, and the way that mouths normally aren't full of teeth. Or stole my key. Or maybe that first part was like a pro... Well, it did say prologue. So maybe I guess I'm this guy. For the rest of the game. Hurt. I could use these rags to craft some bandages and heal myself. the 21st century. Welcome back, Infamous. And yeah, I don't know if you saw my tweet on that subject, Dosner. I'm like, not only are you wasting people's you know, Twitter reads to talk about how people have limited Twitter reads, but you're also talking about how dead Twitter is on the platform that you're claiming is dead. Uh-huh. Okay. What else am I supposed to do here? Can I run at this and... No. Don't have any skills to use yet. Oh, I can use a lockpick. Okay. Yep, that's what I was trying to... There we go. Unlocked. It's heavy, but it's got a good reach. Okay, do-do-do. So let's put the shovel over here. Flashlight. Okay, well, at least my last use of the shovel broke the door open. Ah, congratulations. Yeah, you didn't miss much, Infamous. I spent most of... the first 45 minutes of the stream just getting stuff to work right. Oh, crap. I'm sorry, but I don't know the code. That's also barricaded. I was hoping I could, like, twist the knob or something. Well, these lamps aren't very helpful. Oh, right, the generator's out of generator food. Well, that was part of it, but then I started this and the UI is like halfway off of my screen. So I'm like, all right, well, let's see if I can fix that in settings. And it ended up making it so that my Xbox wasn't displaying anything on screen. And so I had to like restart it in safe mode and switch the output to another TV just to be able to see what was on the screen and get it back to HDMI resolutions. Okay. So, put that there. Hold LT, followed by A to pour the gasoline. There we go. I can save battery on the flashlight here. There we go. Four, eight, nine, two. Okay, thank you. door seems stuck. I need to apply some force to it. Trying. That's the only way I know how to use force. I guess. I mean, it's one of those things where yes, but also you. I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing here. Which, in general, I'm fine with that kind of thing, but not when I'm trying to put on a show. Hold on. Table leg? Okay. Let's see if I can use that. There we go. Oh. Ah. Okay. Why was he holding a rubber chicken? I thought he was dead. No, probably not, but I mean, hear it? I did hear it. Thank you. What the hell? Okay. I made it through the prologue. You know, that's an excellent question, Sprock. One should never be without his rubber duck. Yeah, pretty much. I mean, that's one thing you can say about the PS Plus freebies is, I mean, they give away like at least one AAA game a month. Granted, it's usually like Call of Duty or sports bullshit, but there. Another pattern I've noticed about the PS Plus stuff is that it seems to at least, like, out of the three games they give out, it's usually something that appeals to just about any type of gamer. Like, you may not like all three of the freebies, but you're going to like at least one of them. Okay, I think that's good enough for recording here. Let's So let's go ahead and close this down. More options. Quit. Still can't get the hang of the Xbox UI, but oh well. That's my main PlayStation. So let's go ahead and switch over to that. There we go. We're going to start out with Alan Wake Remastered. I mean, even Xbox doesn't think Xbox is good anymore. Like, I don't know how much you've been paying attention to some of the game news lately, but I can't remember which Xbox head it was. He's like, yeah, we pretty much lost. Like, there's no context, no contest anymore. We screwed up the one generation where it really mattered, and we can't make up that that gap. Yeah, Phil Spencer. It's actually, oddly enough, it's kind of a prequel-ish thing to Control. Like, Control happens in the same universe as Alan Wake. And, in fact, one of the add-on packs for Control deals with the events of Alan Wake. I think this was a 360 exclusive at first. Yeah, it was originally developed by Remedy and Microsoft Game Studios. Don't worry, I barely hear anything either. Wondering if that's, like, on purpose. Yeah, the game was released in May 2010 for the Xbox 360 with a Windows version following in 2012. And it didn't come to PlayStation until 2021 when the remaster hit. They've even put this on Switch. Yeah, there's barely any sound coming through in general. I'm pretty sure that was intentional. Graphics. Okay. I thought that there would be like a performance versus quality mode where I usually put it on performance. Subtitles. Enabled, please. Commentary disabled for now, because this is my first run through. What are the extras? Okay. Nothing I can access now.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake, I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild.
Better hope that they don't have a way of detecting a turbo controller like they did in the original Metal Gear Solid.
It began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
Well, why the hell was the hitchhiker standing in the middle of the lane?
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Nice fake Washington license plate.
Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
All right, well, let's head toward the light.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
What? Hold on. I gotta try this. Okay. It links to a YouTube video. Hold on. Okay. One sec. Let's see here. Copy a link. Let's see. Dang it. Okay. Let's take a look at this. Dang it. Doesn't let me do the embed thing. Well, let's see if I can do it without embed. Page isn't available. Fine. I'll just have to watch it later. I was trying to be all cool. Well, that was nice of him. Showing some unexpected restraint.
You missed your deadline!
Damn. Okay, I dodged a little too early that time.
I realized that the Hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
I'm sure you could come up with a better one. Okay.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Stop!
There you go. I was trying to think of a right thing.
No! No! No!
You just wanted to ask him a question.
There was no way out.
Yeah, hi. Tom the poet related to, what was it, the fisherman? Now it's getting really loud. Good God. Yeah, I'd like to get out. How do I get out? Okay.
Follow the light. You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Yeah, it does have a pretty solid WTF vibe to it.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
Not really.
Follow my light.
I was trying to, but... Well, I mean... Like I said, this was followed up by Control, and... They're going to be tying the two together even more with Alan Wake 2, so...
away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Oh, okay.
Pick up the flashlight.
Working on it.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it.
Now this is pretty interesting. Yeah, I'm working on it. Hold on.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Thanks.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
They're doing a good job of capturing the surrealism of dreams, though, where it's like, yeah, it feels realistic, but it's just completely that particular way of fucked up. Did he go? Oh, cool. Flare gun's fun. I don't think much of this weapon. Okay, yeah, that was pretty fun. But it also feels like it's going to be a very limited resource. Also, like, that was what I was supposed to use at that point. I would actually like to turn off the flashlight, conserve battery, but... Now, you know what? I'm gonna run. The lighthouse is right there. Clever! I was already, like, steering to avoid the barrels, and that's where, like, the debris fell. Very good, gameplay guiding. So subtle it doesn't even feel like guidance.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Dude, you gotta stop eating anchovies right before bedtime. That was a particularly screwed up nightmare.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bain. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Did you get your picture, lady? Or sweetie? I don't know.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Hi. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come
do,
on, let's
do, 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 do. That's a big deer.
Stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to
oh,
the OD
damn it.
I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for...
Why would you go to a town where...
Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom.
Like, isn't this the town he wrote about?
Believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
The sudden stop.
Coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here
do
is
me
no
a
longer.
Favor, Sonny! I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rock.
Collectible thermos?
Don't go in there. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Thanks, that wasn't creepy at all. Yes. And then after that, we will play Alan Take a Piss.
I am so happy this could be arranged.
Here we go.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I can hurt myself anywhere. It's...
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid. Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid.
And I'm a poet, and I wasn't even aware of the fact.
They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Thanks, I didn't really need to know that.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Okay.
That diner was a real nuthouse.
Oh, it's time for a bridge review. Hey, that looks like a very strong shape.
Wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Diver's Isle, huh?
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It kind of is.
Right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight. Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
And I'm guessing that the point of this game is to install that same fear into the player by the end of it.
Ah, there we go. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Hello? Anyone here?
Come on. Gotta be around here somewhere.
Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can roll into an interview later on. Now let's...
Okay, he skirted that nicely.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Aha. Whoops.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Let there be light.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again. It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
How long, though, do you expect that it's going to take for you to get your mojo back? It's not something that's only going to take like a week or two, especially if you've been stuck for 2 years.
Alice? Honey?
Oh, there's another coffee thermos. Kind of a weird sort of collectible.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Oh, so it's that kind of game.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Oh.
Okay.
Surprise!
Oh, that's cool.
What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, 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 just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
I mean, it was a sweet gesture, but I see where he's coming from, too. Okay, I was going to stop, but I have to at least
Alice,
get the...
What the hell?
Generator back up and running. Okay, so the generator's still running.
Alan, help me!
Alice? Alice? Oh no!
Oh no! That was kind of less than convincing.
Keep going, Alan.
Yeah, I exactly, Sprock. She did it was a lovely gesture. But she also probably should have known that he was going to take it that way.
Like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another.
But even if she didn't, yeah, he flew off the handle and shouldn't have.
The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Okay. Well, let's save the footage and switch to the next game. Yeah, we'll do Call of Duty next. Okay. Now, let's see what a full day of downloading gets me. I feel like I'm probably going to have to turn this down a bit. Okay. Well, it's not very loud. I'm just letting the title screen run a little bit so I've got footage for the video. I mean, these games always look amazing. And, you know, Raven is based here in Wisconsin, so I always have to give them that much. It's just a shame that this is pretty much all they're working on nowadays. I wonder how much of the, 175 gigabytes was given over just to this intro cycle. And it's downloading more stuff. I mean, at least that's going quick, but it's probably just like hot fixes and shit. Yeah, I don't have a 120 hertz screen, unfortunately. I'm gonna disable ray tracing just so we've got a good frame rate. I don't see the logo inside the box. At any level. Screw it. Ah, thank you for blanking out my email. By default. No, I don't want to install those right now. So I can't do the campaign. I downloaded, I don't know how many tens of gigabytes, and all I can do is multiplayer. Fine, I'll do a round. I'm gonna mute the microphone. Versus bots. Okay, fine. Okay, that loaded really quick. That sounds like fun.
Free for all. CIA team, defend our freedom.
Well, also, I have a 25 megabits per second max download speed. So I literally have been downloading stuff since 11 a.m. And this didn't even get to the point where it was playable until like 8:20 p.m. There we go. Yay, my first kill. How do I swap weapons? Okay. Triangle. Got it. Aw. So, do people not respawn? Is it just me and this one other, you know, one other guy? Or no, because he's gotten ahead of me in kills now.
Wasted. Tango removed. He's done.
That sounds like fun.
Took her out.
So I'm guessing wherever the attack helicopter is, it's just gonna, like, attack people and I get the kills for it. Sweet. I wanted to try a melee kill. I'm not gonna lie, I love FPSs. I just don't love the hype, and I don't love having I don't love having 200 gigabytes of storage space taken up by a single game, much less an FPS. Stole my kill, you bitch.
Your SAM turret has been destroyed.
Enemy spy plane inbound.
SAM turret's been destroyed, huh? That means that someone's over this way. Mm-hmm.
That's a kill.
Sure is.
Effective shot. Enemy down.
Good God. Yeah, that's pretty nasty. And, you know, with the PS5, you're limited to the internal storage and an SSD. And I only have a 1 terabyte SSD in there, so that gives me like 1.6 terabytes of total storage.
BDA, one down.
One by.
Enemy spy plane inbound.
Ah, finally got taken out. Dang it. Ah, wrong button. Bunch of corpses littering the place.
Hostile spy plane is moving.
Female operator down.
Yeah, no kidding. Oh, okay. There was only three?
Clean shot.
Wouldn't necessarily call that the best play, but... Okay. Well, good. I'm glad I was able to at least play a little bit of this without having to be online. Not quite sure why the screen is still black. That's weird. Wait. Hold on. Gotta get the footage first. Okay, well, I guess we're moving on to Endling a little bit early then. Give me a moment here. Oh, why did you start again? Okay. But yeah, so, okay, check it out. We have the base download. So it was 91 gigabytes just to get to the point where I could play a multiplayer game with bots. The full download, the full main download, is 175. Then we've got another 21 gigabytes, another 26, another 15, another 12, another 17, another 11, another 10, another 3, another 5. This has got to be close to 250 gigabytes by the time it's done. Which, I'll probably let it continue downloading overnight, but that's just... Like, I have... You know what? No, I don't think I will. I have a bandwidth cap on my internet usage. It's like a terabyte or a terabyte and a half. I shouldn't waste it on this. So yeah, I'm just gonna take what I've got, and you know, that's more than enough that to make the video on Thursday. Good God. So, last game tonight, Endling Extinction is Forever. This one was only like 2 or 3 gigabytes. Handy, yes? This is an interesting intro screen. Unfortunately, it doesn't have the actual title. Actually, you know what? There's precedent for that, and I just put the title on the screen in normal text, and it works just fine. The menu down in the corner, though, I have to look right into the ring light to be able to see it. That's not fun. Yay, adaptive triggers. Okay. Don't need any of that. What extras are there? Oh, a trailer. Don't need to see that. Kind of feeling like Never Alone. Oh neat, this takes place in Canada. Diggy Duggy, Diggy Duggy. Oh, that's cool. Don't see too many 2D games where you can, like, strike off in another direction. I mean, yeah, that's also gotta suck for you, but... Oh, man. It's giving me force feedback on the trigger button that I usually use to run. And it's really hard to pull the trigger. And even though I can... can, it's not letting me run because she hurt her leg. I do kind of wish that they'd still put an X button prompt where you can go into the background. Oh, barking in the rain. Yep, yep. Home sweet home. I'm getting a lot of trophies on this one. Well, I've never had to push a button to give birth in a game before, so that's a first. Okay, so aside from changing their colors, what am I supposed to do? Okay. Oh, okay. Hold on. I didn't see the accept thing in the lower right-hand corner, so I probably wasn't holding down the X button far enough. There's our title. Look at that face. Come on, look at that face. Look at your face. Come on. Hop up. There you are. Hi, Siren. Catch fish and mice from pouncing spots. Find food for your cubs. Okay. Okay, so hiding is a thing that I'll need to do. Ah, good, she can run again. Okay. Snuck up on the prey. What am I supposed to do when I get to it? Ah, X to pounce. Friend of mine once described foxes as cat firmware running on dog hardware. You must return home before the night ends. Well, let's go this way. See if we can find something nearby. I love the way that the world is put together, because that bridge back there is where I went the last time. Ooh, I wonder if I can find some fish. You're purring. Yay! A fish! Let's bring this back to the lair. Okay, good. I was gonna say, I'm doing a decent enough job of keeping track of where I am, but glad there's at least that map. What in the world? Don't fall for it. It looks like fun, but I feel like it's a trap. She knows one's missing. Oh. Yummy fish. This way. Well, at least I got to keep the cute little toy, but they are pudgy little buggers. Oh, they've grown up a little bit. Cubs will need time or to be petted to recover from a scary situation. I would be happy to pet the cubs. I felt the nuzzle in the controller when it rubbed up against her leg. Can't run too fast. They have tiny legs. Let's see. Have I gone this way before? I have. Oh, looks like new areas are unlocked. Let's see if I can find some more tasty fish. Nope. Sorry, little guys. Gotta head back. That was silly. Okay, is this the new path? Yeah, this is the new path that was unlocked. Okay, well, they get to run right through it. Okay, I guess there was food right in there. Oh, berries. Okay. Where are the cubs? Oh, there they are. Sorry, was that scary? Bump. Okay. We won't go that way. I can understand how that might have been scary. Trying to find some food. I guess it makes sense that it'd be a little scarce in winter. Yeah, but we need food. Okay. Take this back to the lair. Come on, little rumbly tumblies. You gotta get back to the lair. Got some tasty trash to eat. Okay, yep, keep going this way. Almost there. There we go. They learned how to jump. Cub skills. Okay. Sense. Oh, I see. Okay, next day, I guess. Surprised they didn't learn how to swim. Well, let's see if we can find another fish. I think there was one down this way. Oh, something else that smells tasty this way. I wasn't sneaky enough. Ah. Gotcha. There you go. Kind of weird how dark it looks right now, almost like it's already night. Or twilight. Hmm. What's this? Oh, an apple. Come on, little guys. Man, we gotta get those legs to be longer. I mean, it's kind of cute that they're all short and stubbly, but you guys can't really keep up very well. Oh. Badger, badger, badger. Got up there? Okay, good. Oh, let's see what this badger icon is about. Oh, wait. Let's get some food. Okay. Wrong way. There he is. Okay. So I don't want to go that way. There was something I was getting a prompt to pick up. But the badger kind of fought me off. Ah, that's a fish. Alright, I see a trash bag here. Okay, after you guys are done eating, we should probably head back. Will this take me back? Yes, it will. Okay, good. Come on, little dudes. Oh, we don't need to grab more food. We need to get home. It's getting late. But I'll try to remember that there was some food off in that direction. So this is kind of an interesting survival-ish platformer thing. Love the art style. It's very 2.5D. There we go. Ooh, just barely made it back in time. Did you learn any new skills? Nope. Beware of predators. Okay. So something also unlocked off to the left, so let's go this way. Oh, wait. I've got a scent of my cub. Okay, well, let's go ahead and get some berries really quick since we're past them. A bucket. No fishing. Well, surely that doesn't apply to me. But it probably would apply to whoever's had that fishing pole. Diggy Duggy. Gotcha. Uh-oh. Let's eat quickly here. I don't like the look of that guy. They get quite well nourished out of those berries. What am I supposed to do here? Oh well. Alright, let's head back to the lair. It's probably gonna take quite a while to get back there. Especially since the little guys can't run very fast. Okay. Oh, yeah. I can go this way and then this way. Yeah. That was a good shortcut. Okay. Yep. We're getting there. Come on, fuzzballs. We're almost home. Cutting it close again, but we got there. Cannot win a fight if injured. I can win a fight? Okay. Now can I go this way? Okay. Last time I was going to explore in this direction and got distracted by a new smell. What do we got? Okay. Well, we did detect a smell. Ooh, funny. Dang it. Ah, gotcha. Eat up me hearties. Yeah, I bet that's gonna fill the thing up to full. Come on, there we go. Oh. Bye-bye, siren. It's okay, little guys. Just trying to do the whole comfort pet thing. There we go. Hehe. There we go. Okay. How are we doing? We should probably head back. Because we'd have to... We have to go all the way around. Oops. Went the wrong way. Yep. Yeah. And then I think just up here. Good, good. And there's the lair. Plenty of time to spare. Did they learn anything new from that? No. I was hoping they'd learn to climb. All right, let's do one more day and then we'll wrap up for the night. Or night. Which way have I not gone? Oh, that's the house that I visited. Oh, the badger's moved. Let's go to where he was parked before and see if there's anything interesting over there. There was a fish. next path up. There we go. Yep, I know the berries are there. Yep, there's the fish. Okay. Okay. Let's see if we can go this way. And then this way. Down and then through. Another. Yeah, we're full up on food. They've already got tiny legs. They don't need to be dragging their pudgy little bellies on the ground. How are we doing? Okay, so this path goes around. Good, good. We'll just keep following it. See if we can't find some more berries on the way. No, let's just go straight through. It should take us back to the lair eventually. And hopefully all this swimming will ensure that the cubs learn a new skill. My feet can touch the ground and yours can't. There you go. Alright. And up here. Little guys are getting quite the workout. Still no new skills, but that's fine. That's an interesting little game. To be honest, though, I'm not sure how interesting it was to stream. But I definitely love the look of it. The gameplay is pretty interesting. I gotta say, none of the games really blew me out of the water this month. But none of them really sucked either. So I'll have kind of a tough time ranking them all. I'm actually kind of considering dropping Call of Duty's rank just a little bit because of all of the downloads involved. But let's go ahead and save that gameplay footage. And then I'm going to hand you guys off to Fortifier. He's playing Forsaken tonight. Which, if you're not familiar with Forsaken, but you know about Descent, it's a very similar sort of game. Yeah, I will be back next Tuesday night, continuing along with my playthrough of Phantasy Star 2. So we're looking forward to that. I have still been chatting with Saul Villegas to try to find a time that works better for him for an interview. And apparently Tuesdays work well, and August might work well. So we may set a little bit of time aside for that interview sometime next month. So I'm really looking forward to that. But we're going to go ahead and set up that raid for Forte. Thanks to everybody for dropping by tonight. Always appreciate it. Rest well when you do. And in the meantime, enjoy Fortifier.